So, good afternoon. Today, now we will see another theory of seepage theory of khosla equations. The seepage water does not creep along the outlines of hydraulic structure as started by belief, but on the other hand, this water moves along a set of streamlines. These steady seepage in the vertical plane or homogeneous soil can be expressed by Laplacian equation, that is d square theta upon d square plus d square theta upon dz square is equal to 0, where angle phi is equal to flow potential kh, k of the coefficient of the permeability of soil as defined by Darcy law, and h is residual head at the any point of within the soil. The above equation represent two sets of curve intersecting each other orthogonally. The resultant flow of diagrams show both the curves is called flow net. This is the actual Khosla flow net, and it is a streamlines, and it is the equipotential lines. The dotted line shows equipotential. The continuous line shows streamlines. The streamlines represent the path along which the water flow through the subsoil. Every particles entering the soil at given point upstream the work will trace out its own path and represent streamline. The first streamline follows the bottom contour of the works and the same belief path creep. The remaining streamlines follows smooth curves transiting slowly from the outline of the foundation to semi ellipse as shown as below. An equipotential line represent adjoining of points of equal residual head, hence the piezometer were installed on equipotential lines. The water will rise in all them up to the same level. Every water particles on the AB, that is the A and B, having residual head H is equal to H1, that is the H is equal to H1, and CD, that is the CD, having a residual H is equal to 0, that is the H is equal to 0, and hence AB and CD are equipotential, that is the AB and CD, the line joining AB and CD are the equipotential lines. Then exit gradient. The seepage water exerts as a force of point in which direction of flow a tangential to the streamlines as shown is figure. It is the tangential streamlines. Figure above, this force F, an upward component from the point of where the streamline is, turns upward. This force has maximum disturbing tendency at the exit end because the direction of the force at exit point is vertically upward, and hence full force act as upward component. For the soil grains to remain stable and submerge, the weight of the soil grain force at any point is proportional to the gradient of pressure of the water at the point, that is dp upon dl. This gradient of pressure of water at the exit end is called exit gradient. In other words, in order that the soil particles at exit remain stable, the upward pressure at exit should be safe. In other words, the exit gradient should be safe. Then seepage theory critical gradient, critical exit gradient. The exit critical gradient said to be critical when the upward disturbing force on the grain is just equal to the submerged weight of the grain at the exit, and this is an submerged weight WS unit volume of the as given shown in example. Khosla's method is of independent variables of determine of pressure and exit gradient of seepage below the weir or barrages. In order to know how the seepage below the foundation of the hydraulic structure is taking place, and it is necessary to plot flow net. In other words, it must solve Laplacian equations. This can be accomplished either by mathematical solution of the Laplacian equation or by the electrical analogy method or by graphical sketching. By adjusting the streamlines and equipotential lines with respect to the boundary conditions, these are complicated method are time consuming. Therefore, designing hydraulic structures such as weirs and barrages or previous foundation khoslas has involved a simple, quick and accurate approach called method of independent variables. In this method, a complex profile like of the weir is broken into number of simple profiles, each of which can be solved mathematically. Mathematical solution of flow net for the simple standard profile have been represented in the form of equation given in figure. Slide and curves given the plate which can be used to determine the percentage pressure at the various key points. The simple profile which are most useful for analysis are, first is a straight horizontal floor of negligible thickness within the sheet pipe pile line on upstream end and downstream end. A straight horizontal floor depressed below the bed but without any vertical cutoff. A straight horizontal floor of negligible thickness with sheet pile line at some intermediate points. This is an seepage series. This is the equation of seepage series. This is flow net chart. Exit gradient curves. Seepage theory. The key points are the junction of the floor and the pole lines on the either side of the bottom point of the pile line and the bottom corners. The case of depressed floor, the percentage pressure at these key points for the simple forms into which the complex profile has been broken. So it is valid for the complex profile itself. It corrected for the first correction for the mutual interference of piles, second correction for the thickness of floor, and C correction for the slope of the floor. So these are seepage theories, corrections, mutual interference of piles, and this is the correction applied the percentage of head due to the effect, that is C is equal to 90 root upon D by B into D small d plus D upon B. The B is the distance between two pile lines, capital D is equal to depth of pile line, the influence which has to be determined on the neighboring pile of the depth, and D is to be measured below the level which interference is desired. Small d, the depth of pile on which the effect is considered, and B is the total floor length. Correction of mutual interference piles, the correction of positive of the points, the rear backwater, and subtract for the point forward the direction of flow. This is an equation does not apply to the effect of outer pile and intermediate pile. If the intermediate pile is equal to or similar than outer pile and is at distance less than twice the length of the outer pile, this is the actual thesis of outer pile. Correction of mutual interference of pile, this is an example of correction mutual interference. Suppose in the above figure we are considering the influence of the pile, Number 2 on pile number 1, correcting the pressure C1. Since the point C1 is in the rear, this correction shall be positive, while the correction to be applied E2 due to the pile number 1 shall be negative, since the pile E2 in the forward direction of flow. Similarly, correction C2 due to pile number 3 is the positive, and vertical correction E3 due to pile number 2 is negative. Thank you.